Alice Chapter 6, Lesson 3. For this game, we are going to create a UFO rescue game in Alice. This game was originally part of Project Rise Up from the Georgia Institute of Technology. We're going to keep most of what they came up with and just modify it a little bit to show some of the techniques that we've been learning in Alice this semester. We're going to be following these steps to first of all set up the scene and just program the UFO so it will walk around, or you can drive it around and have the beam come and go. And then for part two, we're going to add our people, we're going to put them into arrays, and then actually code the game. So make sure you do both parts before you stop programming and turn in your code. Now let's get into Alice and start setting up the scene. So we're here in Alice, and we're going to select the grass template. Now I need to set up the scene, so let's click on that button. The first thing we're going to do is position the camera. So if it's not already selected, you're going to come right here and select this camera. Now I want to set its position. So I'm going to have X at 0, I want Y to be 33, and Z to be 0. Let's go ahead and put in those. You see how it kind of zooms it out, so I have a much wider field at this point. Now I actually don't want to see any sky, I want to see only the ground here, so I'm going to change my arrow so that it's just pointing to the ground. So I have the camera facing the ground, and I've got my position all right here. This is just the way that we want the scene to be. Now we're going to add the UFO. Okay, so I can actually just search for it, or I can click on the transportation class. And it's part of the aircraft, and you can see new UFO. So I'm going to drag it onto the scene and see that the name right there is UFO. We have it lowercase because that's the naming convention. Now I want to make some changes to this. So first of all, it's going to be its position. So over here for the X, I want the X to be negative 2. I want the Y to be 5, and I want Z to be 45. Let's make those changes. You can see how the aircraft has moved. Now we're going to rotate the ship so that the tail is on the left. So here's my tail. I'm going to click on my rotation. And it can be a little tricky to do, so you're just going to do your best there. Get our tail here to the left. Now we're going to add the cone that's going to be the beam. So let's go back to our shapes and text, and we want to find the cone. Drag it in here. Okay, and it's going to, I can call it cone. I'm going to change the color to yellow. Over here, I've got, I want to make some changes over here. Right now, everything is linked. You see all this right here? So I'm going to unlink so I can change the shape of my cone. I want to set the width and the height and the depth all to 5. So you see my cone is going to be about the same shape now as the UFO. I want to change the position so it's going to match my ship. So I'm going to set X at negative 2, Y at 0, and Z at 46. So now the cone is right under the ship, and it looks like it's its light beam. The last thing we want to do, we want the cone to move at the same time as the UFO, so I'm going to change its vehicle. So right here, I'm going to go to Vehicle, I'm going to make it this UFO. We have set our scene for this much. We're going to add our people later, so let's click on Edit Code. Now let's just get this spaceship to move. I'm going to come here to my event listeners, and I'm going to add one for my arrow keys. So I'm going to click right here, keyboard. I'm going to do a key press listener. Let's come here to the arrow key press listener. course we have to have an if statement. And then I want to know which key is being pressed. Of course I'm going to have an if statement with true. I'm going to use my is key. I'm going to do the arrow key. Let's start with up. And now, if I do the up key, I want my UFO to move. So I'm going to click on my UFO, and here's the move. And I want it to move forward one. I'm going to change here my details section. I'm going to change the style to begin and end abruptly. That'll actually make it smooth. It seems kind of counterintuitive, but saying it abruptly will actually make it move smoothly. And I'm going to repeat this process for the other arrow keys, but doing for forward, I went forward, or up, I went forward. For the down arrow key, I'm going to go backward. So I'm just going to do more of these event listeners. Let's add the arrow key. Use my if. Use my is key pressed, and this time I'm going to say down, and then I want my UFO, instead of moving forward, it's going to move backward one. So now we're going to match the motion with the key, and then change its style, and then do another one for my if. So I'm going to have left. One more for right. And change the style. So I've got all of my arrow keys here, and when I run it, I should be able to just move my UFO. Just kind of check to see that it's moving in the right direction. If you need to make some changes, so I'm going up, it should go up, and it's kind of moving funny. So you can always kind of make some changes. And so you can change it here in the code, or I can come and set up my scene, and it has to do with the tail here. So if I rotate it again and have the tail facing this way, can hope that it will work a little bit better. So I'm going to try my code again. And sure enough, this time when I go up, so all your keys should be working. And it just seems to work better if we have the tail to the back instead of to the left. Done with this part. The last thing we're going to do for part one is we're going to add people and aliens to our code, to our scene. So let's click on set up the scene again. And you want to have at least three aliens and at least three people. So I'm going to go to my groups. I'm going to come to my characters. And first I'm going to get three aliens. And I can just call them alien 1, 2, and 3, or I can give them names. They look kind of small here on our grass. That's okay. And I've got my three aliens. I'm going to pick some people, and you can just pick kind of whatever you want. So I might pick my aliens. I'm just going to scatter them. So you're going to have at least three aliens and five people. You can have more. One more. Okay, so I have several people and I have three aliens and I've got the basis. Now remember, you can have more if you want. This is kind of the minimum. So the more you have, the harder the game is. When you're finished with this, you can click on edit code. And I recommend that you go ahead and save this. And then we will move on to part two and get the code for the actual game.